I find my Lord and Savior right there. Yes, gaze upon the pages if you dare. It is a book, my Lord and Savior. And you aren't him, no, better yet, there's more. I'm on to you as clouds upon the air. As wind upon the water, I am there. This book is one to life my heart does add. Lamus is it, and you are being bad. To say with me it's not, come on, you know. That book is greater reading, it will show. So much to make us sad and mad and glad. So now you know, like Sesame, Sinbad. So Victor Hugo's novel is the key, which is the way into eternity. Then Angel Richard next to Billy cried. 75. To his own human brother so replied. Dear Billy, I do know Hashem's your God. It was a play I played, a silly mode. And that you have remembered what he said. For you to say when in those times you dread. When others order you around, it's odd. We all know God is Lord is Lord is God. Which he will be forever and a day. We all know that it's funny when I play. Pretending in the voice of Mammon now. To say in hell, that you wound up somehow. Within that place, eternal night and day. Of hell, a place where you would have to stay. With woe, and being forced to change your mind. About your God, whom all of us know kind. About your Lord and Savior, who's Hashem. Les Miserables, silly Billy M. We all know it is not your God. You'll find that we are with you, here and in your mind. That we all love you, each and every one. I was just playing Mammon, just for fun. Next Billy dried himself and going back into the bedroom, then to Billy Mac. His angel hope to Billy Mac, she sung. To answer now the telephone that rung. Dear Billy Mac McBride, answer the phone. Your bath has made you fresh and you are done. It is your dad who's calling you today. So pick it up and see what he will say. Don't let it carry on with its ringtone. Yes, pick it up, it's over there, the one. The phone, Billy, it's dad, pick up right now. Don't wait to ask us what or why or how. 76. He's calling you, don't hesitate and wait. Please answer it before it is too late. To talk with him to understand somehow. What's going on with him? The one you know. He knows what's up. I know it's very odd. That Angel Richard played a silly trick on you, but things are better in a nick. We all know that Hashem's your loving God. And now we're in a different sort of mode. So hurry up, the phone it rings. It's Dad, and see what kind of news he brings. Then Billy Mac to Angel Hope replied. To both the angel and his dad he cried. All right, dear Hope. I'll answer it right now. I'll pick it up and then I'll say hello. You say it is my dad, that's odd somewhat. I did not think to be expecting that. Because not everything is there to know. But how if I am here did dad somehow be able to phone me in this new place? Of head buttressiah? What is the case? Of head buttressiah? I do not know. But nonetheless, I still will quickly go to pick it up and answer in a race. However did he find me in this place? Hello, this is here Billy Mac McBride. I'm on the phone, I'm talking to its side. I'm talking on the phone. Can you hear me? Hello, I'm on the phone now presently. Can you hear me? Perhaps you are outside? I'm on the phone now talking here inside. The place I live. Hello, yes, how are you? It's Billy Mac right now. And this is who? 77. Then Billy's dad to Billy Mac replied. And so to Billy Mac his father cried. Hello, Billy, this is your dad. Hello? It's getting fuzzier, I do not know. Can you hear me? I think that something's wrong. Perhaps you have a bad hookup along. Our phone connection speed connecting's slow. I would now like to talk to you, oh no? I'm here with Grandma, Grandma, yes, and I are on the phone which does not yet comply. We're on the telephone, can you hear me? The phone connection's bad, you're not clearly as coming in for us, I don't know why. And all we hear is static, hello? Hi? It is your father talking to you now. I'm on the telephone. Are you? Oh no. I'm calling you, the static is quite bad. It's Grandma who is calling with your dad. I think I cannot reach to you somehow. I think right now I'm going to have to go. We cannot hear you talking on the phone. Oh my. Grandma, our Billy Mac is gone. As Billy's dad hung up, his Hope replied. And to her husband, Billy Mac, she cried. Your dad and grandma called you now from Earth. They newly made an effort to come forth. He knows that you have died there, and it's bad. And he did sound upset with you, your dad. Because your dad, I say for what it's worth. Somehow he knows you've had a new rebirth. Believes, because men framed you when you died. On Earth, those lies in which those men had pride. On Earth, that you were bad, and hurt some kid. 78. Which wicked men who set you up, they did. They to the public all about you lied. You are alone from them, Billy McBride. Now dad by seance there with his own mom. Your grandma there to whom he did now come. Your mystical own grandma just called you. If only that the real story they knew. That you are good and have a different home. With others here, a home which is for some. On head buttress I where you live. But you your dad and grandma can't forgive. Then Billy Mac unto his angels cried. And to their ears within his breast replied. What do I do? Those men on earth ruined me. It makes me so confusedly angry. Back there my reputation's down the drain. Although I now live here, do I complain? Or have this sort of anger silently? May dad believes some things he cannot see. My dad back there thinks I was a bad man. A bad man who did fail in my own plan. And grandma too because that I was framed. My private art men sold and me they blamed. For hurting someone else, they had a plan. Against my earthly life, that wicked clan. And killed me, now my reputation's gone. And I am here who knows, the only one. It seems I can't do anything again. To get it back, to make it better then. At least I live, though I do feel alone. Shut off from them, for something untrue done. Shut off from all my family back there. What do I do? About me they don't care. 79. Next angel Hope to Billy Mac replied. And to her lovely human husband cried. Dear Billy Mac, he thinks you are in hell. It is unfair, and this won't make you well. Your dad thinks you're in hell because those men who set you up did lie to all back then. He thinks you sold a soul you did not sell. Your dad believes their lies and he can't tell. That you were framed, most all of them don't know. Because their minds aren't quick for this, they're slow. Your whole family and everybody else. They all believe you're in the hell of hells. The friends you had and loved, their love can't show. The friends you had and loved, they all also believe the lies. Those men did cover up your life, the only one you had to cope. Your life, they made it positively seem that you were absolutely bad. Their team did it to make the public think that stuff. And now it is for you a little rough. And now dad thinks you're inside hell to burn. And all your friends and everyone in turn. And Billy wept, then Ariel replied. And angel Ariel to Billy cried. I swear and swear and curse and curse and curse. I swear and swear and curse another verse. I curse and curse and swear and swear and swear. They upset dear Billy, that they did dare. I swear and curse those men to make it worse. I swear and swear and curse and curse and curse. As they did dare, I curse and curse and swear. How did they dare? How did those wicked dare? I swear and swear and curse and curse and curse. 80. And then repeat again the second verse. My swear upon those heads of men back there. My swear because those wicked men did dare. I curse and curse those awful villain men. I may not sound like an angelic woman. They framed a Billy Mac Benavova. They may all be protected by the law. But I shall curse and swear at them again. For profit and for business and for gain. For framing people good as Billy Mac. They all deserve the brunt of my attack. Then Billy Mac to Ariel replied. And to that angel Ariel he cried. Dear angel Ariel, what's this I hear? That you are also vocal, I do fear. That you can cuss, it is quite new to me. I knew that you were hiding quietly. Your anger and frustration, oh my dear. Your vocal anger, it is very clear. I did not know that you could strongly cuss. I did not know your anger, that it was. Or, Well, I know that you do lots of things. But every cuss word to those men each brings upon their heads some worser curse from us. I'm shocked as well to hear that you do cuss. I did not now expect all this from you. And I imagined now your face turned blue. And that you had it in you to swear such. The force of your reproaches is so much that I would never wish to cross you too. This is your way to me as I to you. I know you love me, dear, I know all that. But swearing at those villain people? What? 81. Then Angel hoped to Billy Mac McBride. She called to him, and lovingly replied. It is okay to hear her, Billy Mac. It's just a tack for tick, a tick for tack. And you are not the only one alone. That bout of Ariel's Tourette's syndrome confirms that she does care in that attack. We all love you so much now, Billy Mac. We all love you, and Ariel's long bout. A bout of anger wrapped not in her doubt. Was her Tourette's syndrome which came on now. Is only temporary and somehow. It happens that your angel wife will shout. She wishes that the honest truth were out. We all of us wish people weren't so bad. They all made us a little more than mad. To do those things to you and lie to all. They did. Your reputation had a fall. We understand such trouble makes you sad. Yourself must go to Ariel and add. As Ariel is cursing them, she is. She needs some gentle love, give her a kiss. And Billy kissed his angel dear who cried. And so the unseen Ariel replied. I thank you, Billy Mac, that's very nice. Of you to love me, tenderly and kiss. Your kiss to love me, always I love you. It's time for you again to get up too. To walk outside, it would be very wise. To go about and stroll beneath the skies. The store is a good place about to show. That store is where we want to go right now. To the convenience store on a short walk. 82. Let's go, we'll help you there. I'd like to talk about this planet which you're on somehow. Where everything is similar, you know. Where everything looks just like Earth, the same. The harder place beyond from which you came. But it is not, since ghosts are all around. They look like people walking on the ground. But here to Headbutt Rasaya they came. And Headbutt Rasaya is indeed its name. It's time we go, sometime I'll tell you more about this place. Let's walk now to the store. Then Billy Mac to all his angels cried. To each and every one he thus replied. Okay, I'll take a walk outside and check. Now going on out here upon my trek. The mailbox for the book we wrote, our best Hawaiian sonnets, was to me addressed. It is not in the mailbox. What the heck? I hoped that it would be here now, uncheck. I thought that it was coming, I forgot. I'm not on Earth, on Earth my body's not. I'm not back there. I guess it will not come. Since it was being sent to my Earth home. Where there it was to be found as it ought. But I was killed back there, so it will not be found inside the box. Oh well, I'm here. I'm here alive and breathing this fine air. Alive, for which I'm thankful to be saved. To dwell with ghosts around my fate is paved. Upon this planet, all of that is clear. All right, I think to some place else I'll steer. Okay, I'll take myself into the store. To find out something else I'm looking for. 83. Now Billy checks the mail for a new book. The one which he did write, so he did look within the mailbox, but it wasn't there. And all he found was such a box of air. And Headbutt Rasaya, for what it worth, he realized was not the same as Earth. Then sadly, but with energy he walked. The way he moved was like a robot sparked. He bought some cat food in the market store. And coming back the cars around him soar. The first car thus to Billy Mac McBride. To Billy walking, rushing past replied. An Attabot. He is an Attabot. An Attabot, yes, find him one, you ought. Hey Attabot. An Attabot for sure. An Attabot as if there ever were. A ghost or other creature he is not. An Attabot he is, like a robot. The ghosts and others do not walk like that. We all of us know where to walk whereat. I've seen them walk, it is a common thing. Of that guy walking there I will now sing. When zooming by him passing him somewhat. Hey you there walking, you I'm coming at. Hey Attabot, yes you, I'm passing by. Yes, you there, over there there, by and by. Hey Autobot, I see you walking there. I'm rushing by you going to somewhere. I see you walking Autobot gay guy. I know you hear me as I'm passing by. Go Autobot, yes you, to whom I speak. Go onward down that road for what you seek. The second car to Billy Mac McBride. 84. Did pass him by, and passing so replied. I love you Billy Mac Benavova. I love you always evermore, and ah. I know that you can hear me rushing by. This is your Numa Angel Sister Hi. This is your Numa as a race car, ha. A speedy racing car, your good Numa. I'm rushing by you, here I go, zoom, zoom. There is upon this roadway all the room. I know that you are listening to me. I'm Numa as a speedy car, hee hee. I'm speeding by you on your walk to home. To there I know you're going off to come. I love you Billy, Billy Mac I do. Your Numa loves you all the way, it's true. As sisters should, I love you all the way. I love you much with every night and day. You're doing great, your Numa sis loves you. So keep it up, I'm going, quickly too. I'm speeding off beyond you you can tell. I love you Billy. I am off, farewell. The third car thus to Billy Mac McBride. While speeding by that walking man replied. You're not in hell. You're not in hell, I say. You've managed to keep such a thing at bay. You're not in hell, in nothing of the sort. Don't worry, you've not been judged by a court. And put in hell to dwell there and to stay. You're nowhere near that place, you know the way. You're not in hell, dear Billy Mac McBride. You're not in it nor are you found outside. No place like that forever will you dwell. Don't worry Billy Mac, you're not in hell. 85. You would not even go there if you tried. There is no place like that, Billy McBride. There is no place as hell for folk to go. It would be really bad if it was so. Some people do get far behind the lead. But heaven is a place for all, indeed. There's every reason to be good, you know. So do your best, the beautiful will show. Still people should be good, you know as well. There's heaven after life, but not a hell. Next Billy to the leasing office whites. To get a working order for his lights. His bathroom lights which needed a repair. Just then he saw a man and woman there. The two were talking in a sexy way. And Billy Mac was shocked at their display. The working order was approved, and back. He came into his place. Then Billy Mac, to his dear angels of his heart replied. And to those angel wives of his he cried. This is a weird place, very much for sure. And as I carry on, I feel its cure. First, I was murdered, brought here saved by God. Then, I found out that Jesus being odd, was also here by Hashem saved, what's more. He left me at this place as on its floor. He left his place to look like mine on earth. But it is better, yes, for what it's worth. And I moved there on head but Messiah. This planet looking just like earth, and ha. I find that ghosts are living a new birth. Those ghosts are not like ghosts who spread a dearth. They're children from the Holocaust, who heal. 86. As people here in safety of its seal. As people, ghosts of all ages now here. Upon this happy planet without fear. Except for Nazi cops who are not real. For all of us it is a better deal. Yet, now they think I'm gay and also talked. Insects talk to each other as I walked. Then Angel Hope to Billy Mac McBride. To him the loving angel thus replied. Dear Billy, they are ghosts and talk like that. Dear Billy Mac McBride, you know we state. At times you feel as if you're going mad. But don't think that, that would be very bad. These are the ways of ghosts, and you know what? They love to watch you everywhere you're at. They're impotent as you, just like you now. So don't be much offended, or think, wow. And when they called you Autobot, you must not let them call you that, but trust that Autobots are very bad somehow. Those Autobots into some minds do plow. For Autobots are lonely sorts of things. They do not read nor like what reading brings. They're lonely and unhappy, and they keep distracting folk from ever reading deep. They hate our books, and trash them in their gangs. The Autobots hate books, and human beings. Within their sway can't read their best way taught. So tell those ghosts you're not an Autobot. Then Billy Mac to Angel Hope replied. And to his loving angel wife he cried. As someone takes a gift of larger size. Okay dear Hope, I'll take your good advice. 87. And tell those happy ghosts that I am not. A lonely and unhappy Autobot. Of course I'm not, I'm happy and I'm nice. As nice perhaps as you in paradise. So nicely set with my own angel dears. And though I'm not addicted yet to beers. Yet I think reading I'm addicted to. Those books I love of which I read with you. My reading helps me conquer many fears. It's best to read, sometimes I'm brought to tears. Of joy just thinking I'm a lucky guy. Sometimes my joy I think is very high. To be with you to read all day and night. I'd never let an Autobot delight. In making me distracted, as they try. From books I read, from books of how and why. From books I love. Yes, I will tell them, y'all. Hey ghosts, I'm not an Autobot at all. So Billy moved around his place anew. He quickly sparked a grace, and tightly knew. That inside him his wife, Taub Shbib, was strong. And moving fast like cats, he felt no wrong. As Angel Taub, Taub Shbib helped him move. As from within she worked a graceful groove. 4. With Angel Taub Shbib's sparky graceful aid. Next Billy put a stool right by his bed. And on the stool he put a globe, and then. His Angel Hope replied to Billy M. I know you're still afraid of bully men. Don't worry much at all about them then. 88. Intruding upon you within your home. But you are safe and bully men won't come. Yes, you are safe, so trust me, Billy M. Yes, you are safe when bright or when it's dim. But if you wish, to make you better feel. And if you want to get away to heal. Now take that bottle and the candlesticks. The empty red wine bottle kept for tricks. Illusions which, when made, seem that they're real. Now take those things as if they were a seal. Yes, take those things and put them by the bed. The bed on which sometimes you like to read. So that you can feel safer just in case. The bullies are not coming to this place. But you can have those weapons there instead. To bring you peace that you won't end up dead. To bring you calm of mind, but bullies won't. Come here to beat you up. You worry. Don't. Then with a kindness Billy Mac McBride. Unto his Angel Thrickbut thus replied. I thank you sweetie Angel Thrickbut Hope. I love you very much, your mind is ope. I know you care for me to keep me well. And feeling safe much more, yes, I can tell. I'll put those objects by my bed to cope. With my illusions, which you tell me, nope. With my bad thoughts of bullies which I have. I see you love me too, your love I'll save. I'll trust you that those bullies will not come. To beat me up within this second home. A home arranged for me which Jesus gave. Who made here nice as it as I did have. So thank you Hope, I'm happy you said that. 89. I know the bullies won't to me come it. It is an urgent matter to give trust. To those who know that bullies will not bust. Inside my place to do me harm somewhat. I love you my dear angels, that is that. I love you Hope, and trust your angel mind. Which never lets me down at all I find. So Billy stretched himself out in a bliss. And then his angel Hope to him said this. Dear Billy can you hear it? Listen close. Be silent, give your mouth a silent dose. Of quietude, and listen to the fan. And think about resolving, if you can. What gentle noise that is which you shall hear. The signal's coming stronger, getting clear. The signal's coming like a burst of light. If light could make a sound instead of bright. The signal's like a lighthouse with its beams. But in the form of sounds the pulsing seems. Instead of light there is a pulsing sound. That's coming from your fan upon the ground. The fan within your little kitchen room. A kitchen such wherein you always zoom. To make a meal or wash each dirty hand. The fan is making noises, understand. This time it's different with the blowing breeze. If you be quiet, still and listen, please. You'll understand what this is all about. And of your angel Hope you will not doubt. Then Angel AB unto Billy cried. To Billy Mac that angel so replied. I love you Billy Mac Benavova. I know that you on head but Rasaya. 90. Have had the strangest time about this place. As I am talking, blowing on your face. This breeze, a very gentle fanning breeze. Beyond the kitchen fan in frequencies. You hear me and I know that you can tell. That I'm your angel mother very well. My name is AB, when that you were born. I died in childbirth on that shiny morn. Your brother's name is Richard Rorty, yes. Your sister's honey, you don't have to guess. It is the truth and we are angels true. I know that this is something to you new. But also deep inside your memory. Your family's remembered, and me. I was a graceful ape, you do recall. And after giving birth unto you all. I died and it was in another time. Another life wherefrom we all did climb. Next Billy Mac to Angel AB cried. And to his angel mother so replied. I do remember you and love you, Mom. To meet you once again, for you to come. Back to me in another life somehow. I know you still, a little then and now. I love you very much, it's been a while. It's like some favorite trend came back in style. I understand for many centuries. That you've been waiting happily in these. One day here to return to share with me. The news of you upon some frequency. Which, funny though to others would be, yes. That you to me your spirit could address. Itself within the fan, within its breeze. 91. The fan within my kitchen room with ease. And I believe that I remember much. Of how you were a graceful ape and such. Who died for me, those memories we share. Before when I was born back then, back there. I love you angel mother, it is great. You're here with me upon this special date. Then Angel Hope to Billy Mac McBride. Her loving human husband, so replied. You know your life at this point now, and more. Than you have ever dreamt to know before. Such knowledge is a blessing now and then. To have revealed to you but not to men. These matters of a heavenly sort now. Which you through us do understand somehow. Let me reveal to you next something new. It's new to you, it's knowledge about you. And we already know it since our kind. Is from that heaven which you'll someday find. And this about you, dearest Billy Mac. In heaven you're a gentle woman black. Named Coconut, she is your astral self. And though this revelation is itself. A matter for belief which comes from trust. Of us who love you here and there, it must. Be known that she will be your afterlife. To live with me and every other wife. It may sound silly, but your honey that's. Your sister, you and Richard are bobcats. Next Billy Mac to Angel Hope replied. And to that gorgeous angel thus he cried. Ha! Angel Hope indeed that is a shock. To be a bobcat, that would really rock. 92. Especially to know my astral self. Who's Coconut, and quite a shock itself. A woman black in heaven living life. Up there with you, each special angel wife. It sure is funny I'm a group bobcat. Perhaps that you are joking about that? But yet somehow I know my body there. In heaven's different, better than down here. On head but Rasaya, this place like earth. I laugh because to know this has a worth. Which I can use while speaking with you dears. A worth which helps me overcome my fears. Since I, experiencing this with you. Do share these funny moments, that is true. A bobcat. And your gorgeous angel wife. In heaven with you in my afterlife. These things I'll sort out later in my mind. While now I'm laughing at all such to find. Then Angel Hope to Billy Mac McBride. Her loving human husband, thus replied. Dear Billy Mac, this is a sacred place. It is a kind of spacecraft home palace. Now look around the room and you will see. That every object's meaning is a key. For you to realize, and not to guess. We're all of us here for a reason, yes. You realize this place is for defense. And every object in its own pretense. Creates a narrative around the den. To tell the story of our coming then. Primarily it's for defense, the game. Charades is narrative that you can name. How things around will tell you of your life. 93. Alone and then with every angel wife. The objects that you see are just for you. Before and after stories that are true. All things reveal their secrets finally. The chairs, the decorations set by me. And other angels secretly till now. revealing of the what and why and how. Then Angel Jill to Billy Mac McBride, her very loving husband, thus replied. Dear Billy Mac, Elaine is back on Earth. She is the only one, for what it's worth, who does refuse to let those men tell lies. She thinks so much of you, you realize. And all the lies which all those men have told. To sell your art when after being bold. And framing you by killing you back there. On Earth within your room, that they did dare. Elaine is good, she is the only one. Who's fighting since your reputation's gone. She's fighting very hard to keep alive. Your innocence and goodness in her strive. To help you out, she's mourning your own death. She loved you Billy, loves you in her breath. Is passionate to help your good survive. Which men abused, your innocence did dive. To depths, your memory all people hate. But she, Elaine does not, she thinks you're great. And you will talk to her to help one day. However, now, just wait until we say. Next Billy both to Jill and then a ghost. His neighbor ghost, replied at any cost. Okay dear Jill, I'll wait to talk with her. And I'll be patient, yes, I will not stir. 94. Up trouble, I trust you and what you say. I'll be alright while waiting for that day. It's good to know that someone understands. Who's far away, who dwells on earthly lands. It seems my neighbor's talking next to me. And through the wall, I hear you quietly. I hear you neighbor, ghostly neighbor, yes. Of what you say, I do not have to guess. It sounds important what you're telling now. And it is easy talking, so somehow. I'm open, we can chat, my neighbor ghost. Between the walls of matters happy most. I know you ghosts are ghosts but sometimes I believe that your computer's running, sigh. It's hard to really know it all, therefore. I have to guess what seems the best way or I'll be caught up in skeptic talk, it's true. Now I must get some sleep. Good night to you. So Billy, after talking to the ghost, fell deep asleep, the rest he needed most. 5. Now Billy in the morning heard the sound of many little birds above the ground. He heard but knew the things they spoke about. He understood they talked of him, no doubt. And then he looked around the bedroom's floor. For he had lost his wallet he was sure. When finding it, the ghosts again outside came back, and then ghost one to each replied. That guy, he's gay that's what I say. That man who's in old Jesus Christ's stay. 95. Is gay, no doubt, the one called Billy Mac. He's gay from top to toe, from front to back. He's gay I say, let everybody know. The one they call Binavova, let's show. The world about this Billy guy. To tell the world from here to way up high. That Billy Mac McBride, there is no doubt. That Billy Mac Binavova is out. And everybody here will understand. That Billy Mac is a gay man. Hey Billy I see you, there is no way. That you are nothing but a man who's gay. Tell all the world, tell all the planet here. Our head butt Messiah and make it clear. That gay is any man who's gay can be. Is Billy Mac, without a doubt I see. That man, that Billy Mac McBride. Is gay. Tell everybody here outside. Then ghost the second to the others cried. To all the ghosts outside the ghost replied. Hey, Billy Mac McBride's an Adabot. A normal sort of being he is not. Hey Billy Mac's an Adabot of course. He is an Adabot in fullest force. Hey Billy is an Adabot I'm sure. He's living in that home back there and more. It was the home of Jesus who had moved. The Jesus guy, the one whom we all loved. And Billy Adabot is in his place. He's even got that Adabotic face. But Billy's safe right there, his lease says so. He has a proper lease, that much I know. Though when I think about it, that Jesus, 96, was much a better friend than him to us. But Billy Mac Binavova, who's living now on Head Buttressiah. There is no doubt that he's an Adabot. An Adabot for certain, doubt it not. Hey Billy Adabot, what will you do? When everybody's gonna come for you. And then the first ghost to the others cried. Unto the other ghosts she such replied. Hey Billy Mac McBride is Moby Dick. There is some kind of super magic trick. That makes that guy in Jesus's old place. You know the one with Adabatian face. A creature big, a monster great, a whale. The white one with the white and yellow tail. He's Moby Dick, of course, it all is clear. That Billy Mac is Moby Dick and queer. The gay guy Adabot within those walls. Of Jesus Christ's old place and bedroom halls. Is Moby Dick for sure. I see it with my eyes as ever were. A whale of whiteness, Moby Dick the fish. A white gay guy and Adabot Jewish. A guy, hey Billy, Adabot Supreme. I see you Moby Dick, you're not a dream. That guy inside that Jesus Christ's place. He used to have, with Adabotic face. Is Moby Dick, tell each and every one. That Billy Mac is Moby Dick alone. Therefore the second ghost to each replied. To all of them the funny ghost now cried. Thus Moby Dick is proved an Adabot. An Adabot is what he is, I'm taught. 97. I say that whale is like a mindless brute. An Adabot, a shade as on a root. Below a tree, below a ghost like me. A whale, like Jonah's, living in the sea. The whale's an Adabot, and this is true. An Adabot is Moby Dick. That's new. A lonely and unhappy sort of being. The sort who keeps non-readers functioning. To stay illiterate, and that is bad. Of Adabots who keep us back, we're mad. The Adabots won't help us read our best. They hate the books, and this is not a jest. 4 books to Adabots remain unread. To be caught reading, rather they'd be dead. They'd rather be distractions for us all. Who try and read our best of great or small. And Moby Dick's an Adabot indeed. An Adabot who'd rather us not read. Next to the other ghosts the first ghost cried. And to the others therefore she replied. An Adabot is gay, that's what I said. The books among the world remain unread. Because the Adabots, those awful things, distract their best the mass of human beings. From reading at their best the better books. And thus it is so bad it looks. That people who don't read are far behind. And Adabots, those Adabots we find, are guilty of distracting humankind. They are to blame for he who wastes his mind. And her who wastes her mind, they each fall prey to Adabot distractions in their way. And Adabots are lonely and they're gay. 98. Just like poor Billy Mac upon this day. I see you, Billy Mac, within your home. I see an Adabot you have become. A gay Binevova, an Adabot. That's you. You're one of them, or are you not? An Adabot is gay, what do you say? Are you not so, an Adabot and gay? And then the second ghost to each of them began to them to speak of Billy M. Therefore I say that Moby Dick is gay. He must so be that he is gay, I say. And therefore being Moby Dick McBride. Who's Billy Dick, who's Moby Gay inside? That former place of Jesus Christ, it's true. Until when Jesus moved, and Billy, new, became the newer occupant right there. The one at which we happy ghosts do stare. He's Moby Dick Binevova all day. The Moby Mac, the Adabot who's gay. So tell the world that gay is Moby Dick. And who with truth could ever become sick? It's true that Billy Mac's an Adabot. And gay and Moby Dick too, is it not? So Jesus moved and now we have this Mac. Who's Moby Dick, the white whale not the black? At Adabot distracting us from tales. In books is Moby Dick, the whale of whales. So tell the world outside, here's what you say. That Billy Moby Dick McBride is gay. The childlike play of them went on a while. All Billy and his angels did was smile. But suddenly some banging noise was heard. And then to Billy Mac thus spoke Richard. 99. You hear that, dearest Billy Mac McBride? They're building up a wooden cross outside. Because they're gonna come for you, it's true. And, guess what's next, what all those ghosts will do. They're gonna bust the door ajar and come to get you, then they'll take you from your home. And put you on that cross outside out there. Those banging noises sounding through the air are banging since they're putting up a cross. You will be crucified in your own loss. Your life destroyed on head but Tresiah. As when on earth you were, Binevova. There's nothing you can do to help save you. And Hashem will not save you either too. Your life is over, on a cross they'll put your body, raise it up, they'll raise your butt. Your body way up high for all to see. I'm sorry that you would not hearken me. As to accept that king, when I warned you. To be your lord and savior, mammon true. Then Billy so to Angel Richard cried. And to his angel brother, thus replied. Hey, shut up, Richard, this is getting old. I do know better now than to be told. What's going on by you? It is not true. That ghosts are doing what you say they do. And as you know, I'm numb now to your pranks. You cannot sway my mind like that, so thanks. For your divine concern, but I'm all right. I do not wish to carry on this fight. Because I know you love me, and I'm fine. Your bold remarks are really out of line. Though ghosts may bang around and make some sound. 100. I doubt it certainly they'll come around. To break into my place, for they've been nice. Though sometimes I have told you more than twice. That I do know you're joking, Richard dear. And Richard, I believe you've made it clear. With telling lies before, so give it rest. This is no final judgment nor a test. Upon my life, so shut up, Richard R. You know it's stupid going on this far. Then Angel Richard thus to Billy cried. And to his human brother he replied. I'm playing, I'm just playing with you. Ha! I'm playing, Billy Mac Bina Vova. I think you see that all the ghosts are good. They would not crucify you if they could. And I, of course, was playing, but you're smart. You figured out my silly playful art. I know it's stupid, yes, I know that well. You're safe. Nobody's going into hell. Nor will you become crucified at all. And so this is a safe place, you recall. The ghosts outside were banging, not for you. Sometimes they do that, make some noise, it's true. But they won't hurt you, neither did they make a cross to put you on to make you ache. They are not like that, all those ghosts outside. They will not hurt you, Billy Mac McBride. So take it from your angels like myself. The proof is that it is a fact itself. That angels help you all the time, I know. Much more than what the present time does show. Then Billy Mac unto his angels cried. And to each one of them he so replied. 101. Now that I'm famous on this planet here. On head buttressia, without a fear. And that because I've read a lot of books. And therefore judging by the way it looks. Upon this planet with the ghosts and all. Who have short memories to have recall. Of things they think about, the things like us. The funny things I've learned that they discuss. I have decided that with what I've learned. From books from where my knowledge became earned. Of all the literature that I have read. I think that I would like a chance to lead. A simple movement so that I may teach. The ghosts to read much more, but not to preach. But rather be a sort of guru man. And so a teacher. Yes, that is my plan. I think I have decided this for sure. To help the ghosts to what I know and more. To help them read their best, so I will guide. The ghosts to books to read with love and pride. Next Angel Hope within his gentle breast. To Billy Mac she kindly then addressed. Yes, that, Bina Vova, my Billy dear. Is great to hear that you would like to steer. Those ghosts to learn to read, so we'll help you. To do just that, to be a teacher new. A role models and educators best. We know you care to help out all the rest. The ghosts who live on head buttressia. Who can be helped by you, Bina Vova. Are ghosts who have no long attention span. So, as a sort of friendly guru man. I think you know that you can help them learn. 102. As often reading lets the reader earn. A hope and knowledge, wisdom in her life. And we, your each and every angel wife. Shall all provide a strategy for this. So you can be a teacher in your bliss. Of passion for those books which you have read. To teach the ghosts to read to get ahead. And learn the how and why and who and what. It's excellent you want to work on that. Now Billy Mac to Hope, his angel, cried. And to that loving angel wife replied. That's awesome, Hope, I'd love to have your aid. So I can be their teacher as you said. You know that I believe that we should raise the sparks of knowing up throughout our days. Within our own communities for good. By doing so, by helping as we should. We shall not leave a human being behind. Or ghosts in this case here, it will be kind. To help their sparks within them higher get. To raise their knowing higher I am set. I love them like I loved those human beings. Who back on earth I knew who gave me things. To think about in our community. It would be great to do this beautifully. To help the best I know to teach and reach. My hands to them in kindness, not to preach. But just to be a guru sort of man. And I am very grateful that you can. Give help and guide me guide them to some book. I know and love which into they shall look. Next angel Tob, Tob Shbib to Billy cried. And to her human husband thus replied. 103. Dear Billy, honey, Billy Mac, my dear. Do you have time to listen? Am I clear? It's me, Tob Shbib, your loving angel wife. Who loves you very much in our love life. Do you hear me? I'm talking to you, yes. It's me, Tob Shbib, you do not have to guess. You know me very well, it's patty cake. It's patty cake Tob Shbib, now take a break. From thinking about what you want to do. With all those happy ghosts who bother you. I know that part of you is bothered so. That you do not get privacy to know. Your angel wives better, so take a rest. And listen to me, patty cake, a rest. Your mind from all your worries that you have. You're fine, I say, another day them save. Thus save your worries for another day. It's me, Tob Shbib, your wife, I'd like to say. I love you, yes, but there is something new. There's something else I'd like to say to you. Then Billy Mac to her his angel cried. To angel Tob Tob Shbib he so replied. Yes, yes, dear angel, I am listening. What would you like? By that, I'm gathering. It's something very special, I can tell. You have my open ears, and mind, as well. And, thanks for asking me to rest a bit. From all my worrying, I'm glad for it. You know it's true I have no privacy. For you or for the other angel dears. Yet, I would like to think of them as peers. The ghosts, to help them learn to read their best. So that they might improve, there is no test. 104. I love them, though my privacy is not. A thing I have completely so forgot. They're good but in some way I worry that. By teaching them such as the why and what. And who and how, from books, my time would all. Be spent developing their minds, it shall. Yet take, from us to talk, much time away. But that is that, what would you like to say? Now to Billy Tob Shbib again replied. And to her human husband thus she cried. Can you get me some water, Billy dear? It's time for water, water, water clear. Can you do this, this water getting task? To get some water now is all I ask. Now rise and get for me some water, yes. You know I'd like some, do not second guess. That I need it, water, Billy Mac. So make a line, a water getting track. And pour the water next into a cup. For that is your best reason to get up. To pour the water next into a glass. Please get it, Billy, or this chance will pass. The water, Billy Mac Bina Vova. It's time for water, 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 ah. What other time is best for getting that? So get it now, and later we can chat. You know the wet stuff, water, Billy M. Get up, it's time for water, water when. I say so, Billy Mac, please get it now. Do not delay, get water, yes, somehow. Now Billy next to Angel Tob replied. And to be loving to his wife, he cried. Dear sweetest angel, how can I do that? 105. I thought that silly us could only chat. So how is it that I can do this act? So is it not I'm powerless, the fact? I mostly thought that I was impotent. When I from earth was to this planet sent. And when I got here, was not my soul told. That I'd be impotent and not as bold? And loving you within my mind, I can. Do that forever as I am a man. But physically? I thought there was no way. Since here on this world, head but Rasaya. The ghosts and I, we impotent, are all. If there's a way to do this act I shall. However, I was told that making love was something I can't do, my angel dove. Though I do feel so much of love for you. and you for me, my soul can tell it's true. So how, dear angel, can we find a way? For intimacy now, for a love play. Thus water was the sign for them to love. It was the secret that for which did prove. So Angel Taub to Billy Mac McBride. Her lovely human husband so replied. Give it a try. I know the ghosts see you. But you'll be fine, and I'll be all right too. We really need some time together, yes. It is not now the time to second guess. So Billy, water please, get it right now. Don't question if it's possible somehow. Just love me and I'll love you in return. I understand that you for me still yearn. So do it Billy Mac Binavova. And it will be just right to yell out, ah. 106. I love you, Billy Mac, and you love me. I know that all the ghosts outside can see. You hear, and I'm within your soul, like air. So even with them there I do not care. And neither so should you, just go for it. And let me love you too, I'm in a fit. And yet, you're getting that way too. Yippee. It's time for you to love me tenderly. Ah, Billy, you can do it, give a try. Let's go for it, you can dear, oh my my. Now Billy Mac to his own angel cried. And to the angel Taub Shbib, so replied. Okay, my love, I'll give it now a shot. Taub Shbib, it might just work more so than not. And though the ghosts outside are watching us, I think I'll always love you without fuss. As much right now as ever have before. I love you then and now and more. The future's ours, our angel children's too. Of whom we'll make again with much ado. The time's for more, of loving let us act. You know I'm happy for you, that's a fact. And though I know the ghosts outside will watch. Like you, I do not care, they will not botch. Our trains of thought to come between us now. By making much of what they'll see and how. We are when both of us, in love, are set. To make each other know that fact, and yet. Your spirit touches all my soul and heart. I know you love me too, and those apart. The other angels who did marry us. Okay, my dear Taub Shbib, I'm ready, yes. So she and he made love in from of all. 107. The ghosts were shocked to see them through the wall. And then the first ghost to the others cried. And to those other ghosts she so replied. Oh! What the hell's he doing? What the hell? Do you see what he's doing? Can you tell? Oh, I am shocked. What do my eyes now see? Is Billy Mac McBride now with a she? My God, he's with Taub Shbib. Hey, what the hell? Do you know what they're doing, very well? I thought that he can't do that thing, but, oh! Binavova and Patty Cake are, whoa. Call all the ghosts to see what's happening. To see and then become shocked by something. Hey everybody check it out, that lad. Who moved to Jesus Christ's apartment pad. Who's in the former place of Jesus Christ. Is now with her, Taub Shbib, you get the gist? And, oh, what do you think now, is it true? What they are doing in that place. Who knew? That Billy. Billy Mac Binavova. Could do that, now I see it all end, ah. I know much more about him, but, oh, what? Oh, what the hell's he doing? Look at that. Then Billy Mac to Angel Taub replied. And to his angel wife he gently cried. Wow. Thank you dear Taub Shbib, love, that was great. And I love you, you do not have to wait. For flowers, I shall think to you a spray. Of violets, buttercups, and roses, yet. I won't forget the baby's breath this time. To heights above, the both of us did climb. Though you stay there, I met you there with love. My dearest patty cake, and sweetest dove. 108. Dear God, Hashem, I thank you for my wife. And other angel wives, and all my life. And thank you for my painless rescue then. And children, Ahava Adda, Amen. And thank you, dear Taub Shbib, I'll find some more. Within my memory, some more galore. Of flowers which I'll now think for you dear. Some poppies and hibiscus for you here. Oh I love you, this time we were with each. To be together, yes, puts me in reach. With you, I know and cherish in our play. And always will forever and a day. Next Taub, Tobshbib the gentle angel cried unto her husband, Billy Mac McBride. This is the latest awesome blossom now. It's all a very good one, and somehow we managed, yes, to be together here. To love each other, Billy Mac, my dear. I love you too, and all our angels where. In room boom, they all live, our children there. Who play their music, some you channel, true. For music of some good recordings new. The awesome blossom, it indeed is great. A very awesome blossom number 8. That's very good we were together then. Thank you, Hashem, Ahaba, Amen. I'm glad we had an awesome blossom day. You visited a heaven in that play. And for the ghosts, this head buttressaya is heaven, though you know, Bina Vova, that you will in your better afterlife. To heaven of charades with every wife. You'll one day go to be with us, the rest. 109. Of your own angel wives, it's best. Now Billy Mac to Tobshbib so replied. And to the loving angel thus he cried. Oh, thanks again, Tobshbib, it's very kind of you to spend some time within my mind. That we can be together in our hearts. I love you very much, my life now starts to come together better with such love. A love which every day our angels prove. My heart and mind and soul with you and all feel opened up as if there were no wall to separate our loves, and I love you. This awesome blossom 8 was awesome too. And now and every day, I understand. My life improves to joyful when you hand back me your love, which I do not know why or what I did deserving you from high. And all the other angels whom we feel, whom to each other's presence each reveal. This love and peace and bliss and happiness. I cannot wait to be in heaven, yes. But I will wait for when that time's to come. When I will be in heaven, in our home. Now Billy fed the cats, and Hope replied to him, her husband, Billy Mac McBride. Oh, Billy, don't be worried now, okay? But something now just happened in this day. And when you fed the cats, it will change things. For cats don't eat food here, and feeding brings to you the waters, now, of Lethe, the food they ate for them does not do any good, nor bad for them, but it is true for you. That feeding them brings on the waters blue. 110. Of Lethe. You fed those cats that food, indeed. In head buttressaya they should not feed. So as you gave them cat food, some things changed. Your life out here shall now be rearranged. It's not your fault, you did not mean to do that thing which you should not have done, and you must now find out, alas, what's next in store. There will now be a change again, and more. Your life shall change because you fed each cat. On head buttressaya the case is that if you feed cats, waters so occur. The Lethe waters have now begun to stir. There was a knock upon the door and then a man called Dave, the maintenance man, came in. So Dave to Billy Mac McBride replied. And to the tenant Billy, thus he cried. Hi boss, I'm here to fix your lights, I'm Dave. The maintenance man, I hear a few you have inside your bathroom have gone out and need to be replaced, so I have come indeed to do just that. I know they're hard to turn. To get them loose, there is a trick to learn. And I know how to rotate everyone which has burned out. I hear the light is gone from these light bulbs, so if you do not mind, I'll work on changing them to bright, you'll find. Don't let me be a bother, show the way into your bathroom, and I won't delay you too long, I'll be gone in just a bit. When after changing them next to be lit. So I see your problem, here you go. And now, with some adjustment, light will show. Voila, now there you go, you have more light. 111. To help you brush your teeth when it is night. So thanks, and on my way I'll go along. It's nice to meet you, boss. I'm off. So long. Dave smelled a little bad, and leaving off. Then Billy took the trash out, he was tough. What happened next was Billy crossed a line. A crack upon the pavement that was fine. Then Angel Richard unto Billy cried. And to his human brother, thus replied. Dear Billy, you have now just crossed the line. That crack upon the pavement, do not whine. But you'll be going back to earth right now. That pavement has a crack which you somehow, when crossed, makes for a traveling of time. Back to that planet Earth. It was sublime. Upon this planet, head buttressaya. You know at times I joke, Bine Vova. And I love you, but this is not a jest. I know you also know it was your best. You did in this great world like planet Earth. Which looks identical for what it's worth. Identical to Earth, but things are changed. You're going back to Earth, it's now arranged. You crossed the line, that little sidewalk crack. My dearest brother, Billy, Billy Mac. You know I am not joking, you can tell. That head buttressaya was not a hell. Nor is there one, and yet for every ghost. Each one became an angel, they can boast. Now Billy Mac to Angel Richard cried. And to his angel brother, thus replied. I understand that I am going back. Though Richard, dear, you never seem to lack. 112. Of jokes and joking with me, I can tell. I know that I am going very well. It saddens me that I did cross that line. And I do understand that I'll be fine. A line for space and time, to travel, yes. To Earth again, I do not have to guess. It's funny that outside this building tall, there was an ancient portal after all. Which was technology, a simple crack. When crossing it does take a traveler back. To Earth, the place I started from, alas. The little crack when I, my foot, did pass. Became the waters blue of Lethe for me. I stirred them up, alas, unknowingly. But yet, I feel that all will be all right. At least the whole is good, a good delight. And everything's in order, even though some parts will need some work and love, I know. Then Angel Richard unto Billy cried. And to his human brother, so replied. Hashem right now is placing you on earth. He's giving you some time, a second birth. A birth somewhat before that awful time. When you were killed for nothing but a dime. To fix your reputation, that is why. Hashem, our God, the one who is most high. Is placing, back on earth, your body there. So that your reputation can repair. And it will be a time before those men did kill you. And you must next fix it then. That never will it happen just like that. That such will happen there again whereat. You must still do your best though it's the same. 113. Old planet Earth, your home from which you came. And go again, so do your best and try to not let what did happen, by and by. Therefore, you've got a second chance to live. A better life of which our God does give. You're coming back to Earth upon this day. So be more careful, Billy Mac, okay. Now Billy to his angels gently cried. So to his loving angels, thus replied. Okay, I see. I'm grateful for this chance. To do much better, therefore my entrance does seem to happen at this moment new. My foot's upon the earth again, it's true. My eyes behold the same old place around. Where I was murdered on this earthly ground. And now I breathe again its worldly air. And being back, and walking over there. Up to the mailbox now, what's this I see? The one we made, our book of poetry? The best we made so far, our favorite book. Hawaiian sonnets, that's the package. Look. I thought I'd never see it when I came. To head buttressaya, and I did blame. That separation which from earth did make. Impossible that I would right now take. Our book, as I am taking out right now. From this my earthly mailbox, and somehow. I can by being back on earth again. Ah, what an awesome journey it has been. Now that's the story true, the greater home. Of head buttressaya a place for some. 114. Finis. 115. 116.